Now, we all know that the unilateral cleft lip happens because of the failure of the medial and the nasal process convergence. The muscle from the lateral alar base here, they fuse to unite in the midline. This is the columella right here. And as you can see, in unilateral cleft lip cases, it is bending towards the non-cleft side. This is the non-cleft side, also known as the mesial side. And the cleft side is known as the lateral side. So when this columella bends towards the non-cleft side, the nasal tip will bend towards the cleft side, that is the lateral side. There is flaring of the alar cartilage on the cleft side. The nasal opening is vertical on the non-cleft side while it is horizontal on the cleft side. When you look at the lip, you will find that we have insufficient vermilion thickness and width. There is no nasal seal on the cleft side. And there is inconspicuous white roll. What is white roll? See, this region is the vermilion border. We have the upper border and the lower border. The border between the skin and the lip, this is the upper line. This is known as the white roll. So we have inconspicuous means not really visible white roll. So in Millard's rotation technique, we have two types of flap. We have the rotation flap and we have the advancement flap. The rotation flap is rotated downwards from the non-cleft side and the advancement flap is advanced medially from the cleft side. And basically, we are getting a proper lip after this procedure. Now, as the surgery begins, we have to first mark the landmarks. The first marking will be at the corner of the mouth. We will mark it as 1. Then the second marking is at the alar basis, 0.2. Then the 0.3 is the base of the columella. Then we will mark the center of the philtrum, which is 0.4. And the peaks of the philtrum will be marked as 0.5 and 6. There will be a 0.7 on the cleft side. How do you mark 0.7? You have to identify the prominent white roll and sufficient vermilion thickness. Okay, we need to have a prominent white roll and sufficient vermilion thickness in this region. And we are going to mark a 0.7 here. So this was about the markings. These markings will help in incision. Now let's see the incision design. First, we are going to have a look at the cleft side, which is the medial side. We will start by giving a horizontal cut from the alar base to the nasal floor and then connect this to 0.7. So basically, when you're cutting from the alar base to the nasal floor, this is a horizontal cut. And when you connect it with 0.7, this is a vertical cut. And then we have to extend it through the vermilion. Okay. So when you give this kind of cut, you get this tissue right here, which is the excess tissue. And we have to remove it. This is the hypoplastic tissue that we have to remove. Then coming to incision on the non-cleft side, we're going to give a horizontal cut from the nasal floor to the columella base, which is 0.3. 0.3 will then be connected to 0.6, which is a peak of the philtrum, right? And then we are going to extend it through the vermilion. So here also we have a horizontal cut and a vertical cut. So this was about the facial view. When you look intraorally, you have to give a horizontal cut at the lip alveolar region junction so that you can mobilize the lip segment and bring them close together to fill the defect. After this, we are going to use a hemostat for dissection. You have to separate the orbicularis oris muscle from the skin and the mucosa. And we also have to detach the nasal base from the underlying bone on the cleft side so that the flap advancement can be done. Then once the incisions are made, we're going to do rotation and advancement so that they meet in midline. And then we have to give sutures. We have to minimize scar formation by aligning incision with natural contours. Now, what is the suture sequence? First of all, we're going to suture the orbicularis oris muscle and then skin is sutured and the intraoral mucosa is sutured. Now, the advantage of Millard's technique is that it gives least conspicuous scars. The scars are not really visible because the incision aligns with natural philtral and nasal contours. So this was about the Millard's rotation advancement technique for unilateral complete lip repair. Now we are going